Welcome back to Odds of War. I'm Matt.
I'm John.
And today we've got an awesome battle report of the Sisters of Battle versus the Necrons. Stay tuned.
Today on Odds of War, the Sisters of the Thawed Rose have been tasked with clearing an Imperial dig site of an ancient Xenos threat. The Necrons have been awoken from their slumber from Drill's digging too deep. Their goal? Bring this young race into subjugation. Will the Necrons complete their mind shackle abduction? Or will the Sisters of Battle clear this ancient foe? Find out today on Odds of War.
John, thank you for coming back onto the channel and all that.
Back for vengeance.
Yeah,
hopefully.
Yeah, we've got a battle here that's hyped up by GW mm-hmm. itself, the Sisters yes. and the Necrons. Yeah. So, you've seen the ninth edition.
Oh, yes.
Trailer and everything, yes. right? Yeah. So we're gonna see how much of that we can reenact here. So today, Sisters battle. We're bringing out a big force, right? We're playing in 125. So for the Sisters, what I've got, we've got the leader, as always. I think Carly and I named her Sister Juliet, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So the Sister Juliet, she's the leader of the kill team here. She's a Sister Superior with a chainsword, a bolter, and a bolt pistol. Frag, crack grenades, all the common accoutrements. But she's there. For specialists, we've got our sniper specialist here with a storm bolter. Then we've got two specialists here. They're going to be our comm specialist is going to be the helmeted one. So they're the exact same pose. The difference is that one's got a helmet, one doesn't.
Got it.
So that's how we're going to tell them apart. But the helmeted one is going to be our comm specialist. So you know she's going to be hanging out with the sniper. We'll see what goes with that. Then a new specialist to try for the Sisters, we're going to test it out, is going to be the medic specialist.
Okay.
So just recently on the channel, I did this sort of like tactics video highlighting the medic and the flexibility of the medic specialist. Yeah. So we're going to try that out. We're going to see if we can make use of it in an actual game.
Cool.
So that's the specialists. Then in non-specialists, we've got a sister with a simulacrum, a battle sister with a simulacrum imperialis. That's going to basically give my whole team, except for the arcoflagellants, basically all the battle sisters will have a 5-up invuln now. Okay. So I got power armor, so 3-up armor save, 5-up invuln. You can see how that could be useful.
Yeah.
They have to be within 6 inches of her, though. So that's the...
So destroy the banner is what you're saying.
Yeah. That's why the banner is not a specialist. Yeah. A couple people have asked why I don't run the banner as a specialist. I'm like, I got to diversify the threats, you know. She's too threatening. Just the banner alone is threatening enough. She, like, puts a target on her back. But could you imagine if I made her a specialist on top of that?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I guess I'm killing that first.
Mm-hmm.
Then we've got a flamer sister, battle sister gunner with a flamer. Then we've got two regular battle sisters. And then we've got two arcoflagellants and an endurant,
okay.
which is like the, just like the, you know, hyper, you know, the lieutenant, I guess, maybe of the arcoflagellant unit.
Okay.
But they're super scary in combat. Basically, that's it. It's good in combat, good in shooting. And that's it. Other than that, you know. And then only, you know, so-so really in combat because they hit on fours. We'll see. If they get pumped up by the medic, they get hit with that medic stim shot, mm-hmm. they could get pretty dangerous. So that's them. Unfortunately, the Sisters of Battle are kind of vanilla currently. There's no, they don't have like an order conviction. They don't have like any like a trait like that. So they're just sort of there right now. But you know, a good sister force. Why don't you tell us what you're bringing for the Necrons today?
All right, so for the Necrons, here we have our leader, Triarch Praetorian of the Staff of Light. He's a combat Lich Guard with Sword and Board.
Yep.
Comm Specialist, Immortal with Gauss, Sniper Deathmark.
Okay.
And of course, 4 flayed ones.
And then flayed ones. Like the best unit ever. You've been putting in some work on these guys too. You got some more blood and guts on them.
Oh yeah. They're fun to paint.
I like this one. Does he have like a skeleton on his back? Is that what that is?
Yeah, I don't know he just wanted to take the whole thing with him. So he's just got a skeleton riding on his back. Yeah.
Awesome. And then now so combat with the sword and board for the Lich Guard.
Lich Guard.
So he's got an invuln and save with the with the
5-up.
Shield 5-up. Okay. And then everyone's like a 3-up invuln and stuff.
3-up save.
Or, I'm sorry, 3-up save. Yeah. And he's got the 5-up invuln. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then a sniper with the death mark. That does the mortal wounds, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So that could actually just totally bypass my my super cool save and just be like, just take a mortal. Just die for it. And then your comm specialist there has got a what?
It's a heavy Gauss Blaster.
Heavy Gauss.
It's not a heavy weapon. I shouldn't call it that, but it's just a upgraded Gauss Blaster.
Sure, basically. Yeah. And then so what is that, like strength 5?
Strength 5, yeah.
Strength 5, AP.
I believe it's still minus 1. It's
minus 1.
Been a minute.
Okay.
Check that.
Okay. And then it's just damage 1?
Yep.
It was what, like, was it assault or rapid fire?
Assault.
Assault, okay. Yes. And it was puts out like what, like 2 or 3 shots or something like
actually,
that?
Actually, the Tesla's assault. It's rapid fire.
It's rapid fire too. Rapid fire too. Okay, so it's like a storm bolter where it's like within half range, just pumping out 4 shots. Okay. Yeah, so we each got a little more melee presence than I do, but I got a little more shooting presence than you do, so it'd be a nice balance there. So the mission we're playing today is Mind Shackle Abduction. So it's out of Kill Team Manual 2019. Yeah, it's going to be the Necrons have sort of like ambushed the Sisters of Battle here, and they're going to be trying to mind shackle the leader. So we'll see how that works out. We'll see if maybe the actual mind shackle tactic, right, mind shackle scarabs, actually comes up. We'll see. It'll be interesting. All right. Any other thoughts about the kill teams you wanna chat about?
No, I'm excited. I've never played against Sisters of Battle before in any format, so
interesting to see how it goes. They're fun. They're really fun. They're somewhere in between Marines and Imperial Guard. They're like somewhere in that space, you know. They're not as tough as Marines because they're toughness 3 instead of toughness 4, but they have power armor. They shoot like Marines with a 3-up, you know, but then they only fight on a 4-up, you know. So, and then you got your arcoflagellants, which are they're really interesting. They're like they're people who have like profaned against the Emperor, and then so they've been lobotomized and then roided up and then sent into battle to just like go die for, you know, for your punishment for profaning.
I don't know what's worse, that or like wearing skin, but we'll see.
Either way, it's grimdark.
Yeah,
it's very grimdark. Sure. All right, so those are the kill teams. That's a mission, and we'll get set up and we'll be right back after this. All right, so in the scouting phase, John for the Necrons has picked plant traps. We rolled the d3. He rolled a 1, so he can plant 1 trap on the field. John, which piece would you like to trap?
His eyes are closed, everyone. I'm double checking, don't worry. This one right here.
Okay, great. So we'll go ahead and keep deploying and we'll be right back. All right, so we are all set up for this game of Mind Shackle Abduction. The Sisters of Battle obviously have been tasked with defending this dig site here, this Imperial dig site. You can see the ruins and everything. Upon digging a bit too deep, though, perhaps they've awoken an ancient foe, an ancient menace, the Necrons. The Necrons, of course, tasked with bringing this young upstart civilization under heel here. So there you have it. Sisters of Battle deployed in this sort of column here, and then the Necrons on a wide front out here. Now, the way this mission works is it's 4 turns and then a variable 5th and 6th turn. We get 1 point for each model that we take out of action with any attack or anything like that. And then the Necrons have this ability that if they basically get into combat and with my leader and cause her to be shaken, they get to roll a die, and on a 4-up, they get to implant Mind Shackle Scarabs into her, which then gives them 3 points at the end of the game. And of course, if any team breaks, then that will, if there's only 1 unbroken kill team, that'll be the end of the game there. The unbroken kill team will be the winners. Other than that, it comes down to points. And that's basically it. We do have a couple special tactics for this mission, but we'll go over them if they come up. Now, for the scouting phase, of course, like we already saw, the Necrons chose plant traps. I don't know where the planted trap is, but I'm sure I'm on top of it already, so we'll have to find out. And then for the Sisters of Battle, we selected eliminate sentries, because I thought perhaps with the flayed ones, the Necrons might have selected take forward positions, but alas, to no avail. So that is it. We are all set up. We're ready to go right into the first battle round, starting off with initiative phase. So the Sisters of Battle roll a 3. It's already not looking good. Oh, there it is, the 12. Okay, so 12 to 3. That means the Necrons do have initiative. Charge this Arthroflagellant as well into the comm specialist. Yeah, would you like to take it? You are within half range, so you do get two shots there. Oh, do get a hit. Does get a wound. He's got a 7-up save, so there's no saving. It's just damage 1. Okay, he's a 2-wound model, so he's got a wound. And then the charge is just outside of 8, so I'm looking for an 8. So you get it. Just get it. All right, so we are at the end of the movement phase here for round 1. Bit of an interesting one. So, John, tell us what you did with the Necron, since you did have initiative.
Yes, I actually kind of just moved everyone up a little bit.
Yeah, so everyone just kind of shambled forward, right? Yeah. Kind of still sleepy from their years of
moved the sniper to be close to the comms.
Yes. So now the comms is within 6 inches of the sniper over here, which is good. Yep. And that was pretty much it, right?
Yeah.
Now, at the start of the movement phase, I used my medic, who was right here, to stim shot this Arcoflagellant here. So he's got the +1 attack. And with him, of course, I charged into your flayed one. I rolled an 8, so I got plenty of movement to go around behind. Then this Arcoflagellant here charged your comm specialist, taking a wound on the way in on Overwatch. Oh, I actually forgot. They do have a 5-up feel no pain. So let's see. Do I get it? No. Okay, yeah. So he did officially take a wound. And then with my Battle Sister Gunner with the Flamer here, I advanced rolling a 4, getting a 10-inch. So now I'm within easy Flamer range of a couple of these flayed ones. My Medic moved over here because assuming that things go poorly on this side, I need to start moving some of my sisters away from that flank. And then everyone in here, I was really afraid of the trap because I knew I had to move something. I thought maybe this would be the trap. It wasn't. So I got really afraid because basically if I move anyone else in this pocket and something like this is the trap, then it's going to blow up in my face and cause this giant mortal wound bomb. So I just readied everyone here in the hopes that maybe I can shoot my way out, take a little pressure off of them and then move when I need to. So that's it for the movement phase here for round 1. So we're going to go into the shooting phase. Next, starting off with the player with initiative and readied models. So obviously you have no readied models because everything moved. Right. So that means it's going to be a slew of firepower over here from the sisters. We're going to go ahead and figure out what we're doing with that, and we'll be right back. We got readied models up first. That's going to be this whole pocket. Just to talk about it really quick, the Endurant here, of course, has no ranged weapons. Our battle sister, our superior, can only really take a pot shot anyway, thanks to the range and obscurement. Now, these two sisters and the Simulacrum sister can see both of these models and this flayed one here thanks to the hole through this terrain piece. And then this sister can see across to here. And then unfortunately, my sniper sister has no line of sight on anyone. So we're just going to go ahead and run through these really quick. We're going to be firing this sister first off into your combat specialist. So we are, I should have checked my half range. Should have checked my 12 inches. Yeah. Yes. Yes. No. No. Okay. So these two sisters are within half range here. So we'll go ahead and fire them first. So the first sister with her bolter into your combat specialist. Two hits with sixes. That's pretty nice to start off. Strength 4 to toughness 5. So 5's to wound. We do get one wound at no AP. Oh.
Okay.
So is he a multi-wound model? He's got to at least have two wounds, right? With that big beefy body? That big beefy Necron body?
Yes, two wounds.
Two wounds. Okay, so he's taken a wound. So that's already really good for the sisters. So we'll go ahead and we'll fire off the second sister over here that's within half range. That's going to be two fails because it's threes, but he is obscured thanks to the rock there. So they're done. We'll move on to the Simulacrum sister here. She'll fire, I think, into just the same model. Now we are outside of 12 here, so these are going to be hitting on fives. We do get the hit with the six there, so then wounding on fives. No wound there, so she's done. Now remember, our sniper specialist here is out of range of, or out of line of sight of anything. We'll go to this sister. She'll actually fire through the terrain piece here into the flayed one. It's just going to be a single shot because we're outside of half range, looking for a five. We do get a hit with the six, and now that's strength 4 for her bolter to toughness
4.
So 4's to wounds. No wound there, unfortunate. And then last thing, we'll just take, again, a pot shot here with the Sister Superior across to the flayed one here. A single shot on a 5 up? No. Okay. So that's it for readied models. Everything in this pocket's fired here. Now we go to non-readied models. Player with initiative is, of course, the Necrons. So it's the Necrons' time to strike back. So who would you like to fire?
The sniper is going to fire.
So we're going to fire a sniper specialist, and who's he going to fire into?
Let's see. They check some ranges.
All right, yep. Within six. So comms up the sniper specialist there. Very good.
I'm going to shoot the medic.
So. And so then the sniper is firing across here to the medic. That is outside of half range. Mm-hmm. But thanks to the... what is the gun called? It's like a... This is like a Necron thing, right? They basically, they ignore the penalty for long range.
Yeah, synaptic disintegrator.
Yes. So thanks to the synaptic disintegrator... We ignore the penalty for long range, but we still only get the one shot.
Yeah.
Now, but probably obscured.
On a six up, there's a mortal wound.
Right, right. Probably obscured thanks to this barrier, but then that's counteracted by the comm. So it's a single shot hitting on a 3,
mm-hmm.
re-rolling ones, yes.
And then...
Oh, are we going to use a stratagem?
Yeah,
or a tactic?
We're going to use a shared disintegration because I really want to kill the
okay.
medic.
Okay, and what is that? Is that one or much. Two command
it's
points?
One command point.
One command point.
Before death mark shoots until the end of the phase, may reroll dice to hit with this model.
Okay, so you're rerolling ones and twos.
Ones and twos.
You could actually reroll even something else if you just really want to dig for that six.
Yep.
All right, so here we go. The synaptic disintegrator, assured disintegration, going into the medic specialist, a single shot, rerolling. It's a hit with the 3. Do you want to reroll it or you want to keep it? She could. You could fish for that six.
So unlucky.
Ooh, 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 he's going to reroll it. Oh, my gosh. I thought for a minute. Okay, so so it does hit now. And now what's the strength of the disintegrator?
Strength 4.
Strength 4 to toughness 3 means a 3 to wound. Gets the wound. AP on that?
AP 0.
AP 0. So 3 up armor save. Oh, which I fail. I fail it. Okay. And then damage 1 is enough to take her to an injury roll. So go ahead and roll the injury roll here. Oh, she's out of action. The medic is gone. And that does put you on the board with 1 point there. So now we flip back over to the sisters. We're going to fire off with our flamer sister here. Now, for those of you wondering, my comm specialist is right here. I was planning on commsing my medic, although now that's no longer an option. But so we'll fire off our flamer sister here. She'll fire into, we'll make this flayed one our primary target, and then we'll split off shots. We'll see how it goes. We'll see what we split depending on what we roll. So a D6 auto hits. We get six. That's very nice. So what I'll do, I'll split three here and three into this one. Okay. So we'll do the first three into the main target here, looking for fours to wounds. We don't get a single wound. That's a three, three, and a two. So we'll go ahead and we'll go into the secondary target. Again, fours to, oh no. Well, that's no good. Okay, so that's it. She's fired. And I think, now do either of these guys over here have ranged weapons?
The Praetorian does.
Okay, so like then 12 our, inches. Yeah, so our, 12 inches.
Yeah, I don't think he's,
I don't think you would think you might be out here. Yeah, just out. Okay, just, so then that brings us then to the end of the shooting phase, because everything else that could shoot is either, oh no, you're in.
I don't know.
Okay, yeah, yeah, no, you're in. Yeah, so go ahead and take that then.
This is, so Staff of Light ranged.
So this is a Staff of Light from our Praetorian here into this Battle Sister right here. So, looks like a single shot. A five will definitely hit.
Yep, strength five.
Strength five, so threes to wound. No wound. Okay, there we go. So that does officially bring us into the end of the shooting phase and into the combat phase, where we've got our combat here and our combat here. So what I'm going to do, neither of us have, well, you don't have any command points to interrupt. So we're both on a single command point. So you can't interrupt. So I've got my charters first. So I'll actually go ahead and I'll give, I'm not going to bury the lead. So my arcoflagellin here, it's got two attacks, but then a third attack for being stem shot. And now the arco flails is D3 hit rolls per attack. So 3D3 attacks. So we've got 2, 3, 4 attacks with that roll. Hitting on fours. So we get two hits, but then the special rule zealot for the arco flagellants lets me reroll those. So there we go. We get four hits. Strength five to toughness four is threes to wound. So we get two wounds off of that. And these are at AP minus one.
Okay, so.
Fives to save, yep. Fails one, makes one, and then they're, it's damage one, and they're one wound models?
Yes.
All right, so then we get our injury roll. Our injury roll is a three, so it's just a flesh wound for that guy. Lucky for him. So now we'll move over into the next arcoflagellant here. Two attacks for him, which is 2d3. So then that's four attacks. All right, hitting on fours, but re-rolling thanks to Zealot. Ooh, there we go. We get a full spread of hits. Now, the Immortal is also toughness four, right?
Toughness four, yeah.
Yeah, so threes to wound again. Okay, there we go. Three wounds. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. Three wounds at AP minus one for your Immortal, sir. Okay,
so looking for fours.
Oh, makes two, but fails one, and he's a one-wound model as well, right?
Yes.
All right, so injury roll, looking for a four up here. Ooh, that's it. He's out of action. Putting the sisters on the board with one point. And then I'll just take my little three-inch.
Well.
Consolidate there. All right, and then now that brings us into fighting with your flayed one here. So he's got what, two attacks or three attacks, something like that?
He's got three attacks.
Three attacks. Now he does have a minus one to hit thanks to that flesh wound.
Okay, so you'd be hitting on fours. So
three attacks, hitting on fours. Oh, he's hit twice. Now he's failed that one. Do these guys get to, we actually didn't mention your dynastic code, right? We forgot to mention that. In the beginning,
yeah,
which is Novok, right?
Yeah.
Which is the awakened
by murder.
Murder, which allows them to.
It's
someone gets to reroll here.
Someone
gets
to right? Look it up.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. So okay, yes. So thanks to Novok, which we forgot to mention earlier, we do get to reroll that two there. So that's the reroll the hit there for Novok, which hits. Okay, and then now, strength on that guy is what, four?
Strength four.
Strength four to toughness three for the arcoflagellant. So threes to wound here, but then you get to reroll those wounds.
For the flare claws.
For the flare claws, very nice. There we go, three wounds. All right, now I have a seven up save for the arcoflagellant there. So he's not getting a save, but I do have a five up berserk killing machine ignore wounds. So we can roll a couple fives here. We do roll one, but we fail two, which means that he is forced into the injury test. So go ahead and roll that. It is a four. He is out of action. Ouch. That's another point on the board there for the Necrons. Okay. And then now he could actually take a three-inch consolidate if he wants. So he could go to there if he wants. All right. So that brings us to the morale phase. So in the morale phase, sisters have two models out of action and no flesh wounds on the board. So no break check required. And because of no flesh wounds, no nerve checks required. The Necrons have one out of action and one on a flesh wound. So no break check. And then you would take a nerve check here, but like your leadership is like 10, right? Yeah, so nothing there. So that is it for round one. Current standing, we're both, so you're at 2 points, I'm at 1 point, and we'll go in to round two, initiative phase. So sisters roll an 8, which is pretty good. Oh, and the Necrons with the 11 again, taking the initiative, albeit barely. We'll take our moves and we'll be right back. It is the end of the movement phase for round two. The Necrons closing in on the beleaguered Sisters of Battle. Meanwhile, the Sisters trying to dig in deep into the Necron flank here. We'll see what happens. So, John, you had initiative again. Tell us what you did with the old Krons.
So, two Flavelins kind of moved up into the ruins to try to get into your lines a little bit.
Right.
Praetorian flew over.
Yes. Here. Yeah. You told me he had fly. I was not prepared for that. Yeah, I did not expect that at all.
Little jetpacks. It's great.
Yeah.
The Lich Guard just made his charge.
Yep. Just barely. This flayed one, unfortunately.
Just missed his charge.
Just missed. Yeah.
We got in back here.
Right. Long bomb charge from this flayed one. Well, long as in like he was here and he ran all the way around. Yeah. Yep.
And then Cypress is ready.
Ready. Yep. And then now for the sisters, I don't have enough die to signify it, but I readied here. Now, we triggered the trap here when I took my leader, moved in over here. Thankfully, we've passed both the initial trap roll, and then these two sisters moved out from this area, having to take their difficult terrain test. Thankfully, just barely passing, so they're okay. And then she's been locked in combat. I charged in my Endurant into your leader here to try to take him out, and then I've readied both my sniper and my comm specialist here. So that is it for movement phase. Both players sitting on 3 CP, so it could be a bit of a spicy round as far as that goes. Now, it is the shooting phase. So we start off with readied models and player with initiative. So we're over here on the death mark. So
actually, we're over here right here because he's going to use my shackle scarabs.
Okay.
So I'm going to roll 2d6, and if the result
at the start
is,
of the shooting phase. Yeah. Okay. So 2 CP gone for you. Yeah.
If it's higher than the leadership of the model I choose, I get to immediately shoot with one of their weapons.
Okay. Now, and what's the range on that?
6 inches.
6 inches. Oh boy. So who are you targeting?
I think I'll choose the sniper.
Choosing the sniper. Okay. I'll double check. I'm pretty sure her leadership is 7, but we'll roll and see if it even matters. Well, ooh, she's definitely higher than leadership 4. Unfortunate. It is Mind Shackle Abduction, but the Mind Shackle Scarabs won't be happening today. By the way, you'll notice some scarabs here. That's the trap. They've jumped out and started munching on people's legs and that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. All right. So then we are back over onto our
death mark
here.
Yeah. So this is the...
That's the gunner with the flamer. Yeah, that's the flamer sister. She is readied. I just don't have the dice to signify it.
Trying to see if there's any better.
You could targets. Fire into this normal sister here or the battle sister with the simulacrum. But I do think she's your best target because you're within half range.
Yeah, the banner is a good target, but I want to get the...
Yeah, so you'll get two shots there. You will be hitting on fours, though, because of obscurement, thanks to all this jank in the middle here. So two shots hitting on fours. Two hits. Okay. Threes to wound, right? Strength four to toughness three. One wound. Okay. And AP is zero, right? Yeah. So three up armor save. She makes it. There we go. She is the bulwark upon which the enemies of the Imperium are shattered. So actually, we'll go over here. I could fire her next. Now we've got that die freed up to signify her. I am going to go with my sniper specialist next, though. She is going to fire. She'll accept the comms benefit now, and she's just going to fire everything into this flayed one here who missed his charge. Now, what's the save characteristic on a flayed one?
Leave it for it.
A four up? Yeah, so I am going to go ahead and spend two CP of my own, dropping down to one, for Blessed Bolts. So now her Storm Bolter is AP minus two and a flat damage two. So that's going to be four shots. We're within half range. You're unobscured. With the comms, that means hitting on twos. So four shots, hitting on twos, rerolling ones because of sniper specialism. Thank goodness, because we're going to reroll those.
And replace them.
Okay. Well, there you go. So that's two hits. These are going to be fours to wound now. So just barely. So it is one wound. It's AP minus two. So you do get a six up save here. No, and it is damage two, so injury roll here, 2d6, picking the highest. It's a four. He is out of action, bringing the sisters up even on the board here, 2-2. So that's her fired. Now, you don't have any other readied model. Actually, you don't have any other shooting because you're in combat here. So then I'll just fire with this sister here as a readied model. She may not have... Okay, she can just barely see this guy over here. So she'll fire there. I don't think I'm within 12 there. So it might be just a single shot hitting on a five. We'll see.
Which one?
This flayed one here. So basically...
Shooting with which one?
With her. Are we within 12? Oh, yeah, we are. Okay, so it's two shots and I'll be hitting on fours. Two shots hitting on fours. Okay, a lot of build up for nothing there. All right, so she's done. And then the last readied model for the sisters is right here. She'll fire into the only valid target, which is this flayed one. D6 auto hits for two auto hits. Wounding on fours. No wounds. Can I roll more twos this round? We will find out. So that's her fired. So now we do have, we just have our leader here. And these two sisters left to fire. I just need to check their sight lines and range. All right, so once again, poor Sister Juliet has no sight lines on anyone. That would be a legal target. So it's just these two sisters here. Our Simulacrum sister and our normal sister here, both firing into the death mark. Now, the sister in front is within half range, but our Simulacrum sister is out. So we're just going to go ahead and do her first. A single shot hitting on a five up because of obscurement and long range. Nope. And then our sister in front, two shots hitting on a four up because of obscurement, does get one hit. Forced to wound. Gets the wound. AP zero onto your death mark, my friend. He makes the save. Okay. And that brings us to the end of the shooting phase. So we move into the charge, or sorry, excuse me, the fight phase. So we're in the fight phase. We've got a combat here, a combat here, and a combat here. Now, Necrons have initiative and have the charging models, so you can either activate here or here first, whichever you...
Go here first.
Yeah, really? Okay, let's see it. All right. Well, actually, I don't know why I reacted that way, because I thought for a minute I could interrupt here, but I forgot that I spent my command points, because I'm a dum-dum. So there we go. So it is the Sword and Board Lich Guard into this poor, poor Sister of Battle. How many attacks does he have?
Two attacks. Hyperspace Sword, Strength 6.
Ooh, strength six. So hitting on threes, I assume. Yep. Okay. Novak, yes.
Awakened but murder.
Yep. Oh, two hits. Okay. Strength six to toughness three is twos to wound.
No rerolls there.
Okay. Just one wound. AP?
AP minus three.
Minus three. So it would be a six up, but thankfully the simulacrum, the Axe of Faith save gets boosted to a five up and it comes in clutch. There we go. She saves it. Very nice. So then we move over actually into my Endurant because we trade off here. So that's three attacks for the Endurant, which becomes D3 hit rolls for each attack. So 3D3. So that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 attacks here for the Endurant. Hitting on fours, but getting to, oh God, thank goodness for the Zealot rule, getting to reroll all of those. Okay, pretty good, pretty good. It comes out to 5 hits. And strength 5 to toughness 5. So 4s to wound. No rerolling the wounds there, though. So it's 2 wounds at -1.
So force.
Fails 1, saves 1. It's just damage 1. I take it he's a 2 wound model, mm-hmm. right? So he'll just take a wound there. Okay, and then now... There we go. Now they're done. And we'll go over here into your flayed one, into my arco-flagellant. This is an important combat here, actually, because if you don't kill me and I kill you back, then I've got carte blanche right into that sniper specialist of yours. So let's see it. So three attacks from the flayed one. Gets one hit, but gets to reroll the hits because of Novak. Still only one hit.
Hitting on threes.
Oh, that's right, because the other one had a flesh wound. So, sorry, two hits. Now wounding on threes and getting to reroll those. Two wounds, so no save, but of course I do get my 5-up Berserk Killing Machine save, which we do save one, so it's only a wound, except that I already had a wound. So it's two, so it's an injury roll. He's out of action. That's rough. That's not good for the sisters. All right, and then we'll fix our pylons and consolidates here in just a second. Now we do have your leader into the Endurant.
So Staff of Light melee is going to be 2 attacks, strength 5.
2 attacks, 2 hits there, a 4 and a 6. Strength 5, toughness 3 is 3s to wound. It's 2 wounds. AP doesn't matter because I have a 7-up save. What's the damage characteristic on
it's
that?
It's a 1.
It's 1. Okay, so just need to make these 5-up Berserk Killing Machine saves. No! Injury roll for the Endurant. Oh, it's just a flesh wound. Whew. All right, things are starting to look a bit dicey here. So that brings us into the morale phase. Sisters of Battle have 3 out of action and a 4th on a flesh wound. So no break check yet, but we do need to take a nerve check here for this one. So a +3 to the roll. And I don't think I'm within 2 inches there to fix morale. No, I'm just out. So a plus three to the roll. So as long as I roll a 1 through 4, I'm okay. No, she's shaken. The Endurant shaken. Ouch. For the Necrons, 2 out of action and no flesh wounds, meaning no break check required, no nerve check required. Ooh, this is turning into an interesting one. So we'll go ahead into round 3 here, initiative phase. Sisters rolling an 8. Oh, it's happened. Finally, the sisters have taken initiative since the Necrons rolled a 3. We'll take our moves. Round 3 movement phase is over. Just to talk about something you might have seen us do on the movement cam. So we did consolidate in here after the combat phase of the last round, meaning that this sister would get to strike. We did roll it out and nothing. I did wound, but then your flayed one saved. So movement phase for the sisters was pretty simple. Endurant here is shaken, so she had to stay in. I elected to stay in combat here only because I wanted to be able to continue to body block you. I didn't want to give you free movement closer to my models. Then these two, my comms and sniper specialist, moved here, staying outside of the dangerous terrain. My leader moved out this way again, same sort of thing, getting out of the difficult or dangerous terrain, past the dangerous terrain test. My simulacrum bearer, she moved out as well. And then this regular battle sister moved here just to try to body block this passageway. I elected to stay in combat here as well, as because I do have a 3-up armor save, and I might just be able to eke that out and clog you up a bit more, giving my shooting element here time to deal with this here. And then, John, tell us what you've done with the old Krons.
All right, so sniper readied. This flavor over here got a charge off, and then
yep.
The one that's hiding in the ruin.
Yes, charge didn't make
it was like a 3-inch charge or something.
Yeah, so, just kind of hanging there. And then electing to stay in combat here because mm-hmm. you want to go choppy chop.
Absolutely.
All right. So current standings, Necrons on 3 points, Sisters on 2 points, and both of us with 3 command points, thanks to us both being rather miserly with our command points. So with that, it does bring us into the shooting phase. We only have the one readied model here, which is your sniper specialist. So who would you like to fire at?
Actually, I think, because it's so good and so thematic.
Are you going to try to mind shackle scarab again?
I'm going to try to mind shackle scarab again.
All right. And I assume this will be your only target here, will be this bolter sister.
It's...
Because it's within 6 inches?
6 inches of a model in your kill team. So I can choose any model
right,
within
but,
6 inches.
Oh, yeah. You're right. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. So, yeah. So you could... Yeah, you could choose this sister. You could choose here. You could choose my banner
the
sister.
Flamer.
Oh. The flamer.
Yeah, I think I'll choose the flamer. And then we'll see if I get it.
Okay.
So that's 2 command points.
So 2 command points down for the Necrons. We're going to try to mind shackle Scarab, our sister here. I'm pretty sure it's leadership 7, so we'll see. We'll roll, see if it matters. So. She's less than a leadership 9. Right. So now before we do this, guys, just let us know down in the comments. We've had this come up in a previous game about being in combat, shooting into combat, mind shackle scarabs, all that stuff. We didn't find an answer in any FAQs, but you let us know what you think. Yeah. If this
pick
is
any model within 6 inches of a model from your kill team and roll 2d6. If the result is higher than the enemy leadership characteristic, immediately make a shooting attack with one of the model's ranged weapons.
Right. Yeah. So it's really just whether or not she has like the legal target into one of these other sisters here or something. But that's, so who are you going to fire in? I guess that's really the question.
I guess I want to do the banner.
Yeah, I think she's your legal target there. So D6 auto hits with her then. Oh my gosh, it's the big 6. It's wounding on 3s because that's a strength 4 flamer to a toughness 3 sister. 1, 2, 3. 3 wounds. 3. 3 up saves. Oh, we make them all.
Right.
Well, there you go. Mind Shackle Scarabs did go off, but thankfully my faith was stronger, or at least the power armor was. All right. So then we go back over to your sniper specialist here.
Let's see.
I'd imagine firing into.
Yeah, we'll go for the leader.
Yeah, makes sense. So it'll be a single shot. It'll be hitting on 4s thanks to obscurement here from the terrain piece. And re-rolling 1s. Gets the hit. Okay. 3s to wound. Gets the wound. Oh, that's the mortal wound one.
That's the mortal.
Because you got the 6 on the wound roll. So I think that's just straight to injury roll, my friend.
Yep.
That's pretty scary.
Each time you roll a wound of a 6+ for this weapon, the target suffers more wound.
Yep.
In addition to any other damage.
So there you go. Injury roll. Oh, okay. Thank goodness. Unless you want to re-roll that.
I think I need to.
Oh, yeah. I think you owe it to yourself, too. Yeah. So re-rolling it.
There we go.
Oh, it's out of action. The sister's leader is out of action. So that is another point for the Necrons. But you can no longer mind shackle abduct her, which is also... okay, I guess. It's not great for the sisters, but it's not the worst thing in the world either. If I can just somehow stabilize as I'm just bleeding models, we'll be okay. All right, so that's it for readied models we fired there. So it's just going to be a little bit of shooting from the sisters here. So we're in combat here. We're in combat here. We've got basically our banner sister. We've got our sniper and our comms. Now our sniper specialist is going to fire. I believe I'd be within 12 inches here. Yes. Yeah, so I'm within 12 inches of the guy within the ruins here. Now that my leader is gone, I better not just go willy-nilly with the command point. So I'm within 12 inches. You will be obscured, but I'll take the comms bonus. So I'll at least be hitting on threes, rerolling ones. I'm not going to use blessed bolts here, only because I want to save the command points because now my leader is dead. But it will be four shots, hitting on threes, rerolling ones, two twos. It's the classics. Wounding on fours. We do get one wound there at no AP. Well, it was just one wound, yep. So... Just reroll that thing. Okay, well, there you go. The dice gods willed it, so he's passed. Then we'll just sling two bolter shots from this sister into the same target. These ones are, of course, hitting on fours because of obscurement. A single hit, wounding on fours. Gets the wound, no AP. Makes it. Okay. And then lastly, then we do have our battle sister here with the simulacrum firing through this little doorway into the same target. Two shots hitting on fives, nothing. Okay. That's it for the sisters. Things are starting to look dire for them as we enter the combat phase for round three. Starting off with charging models will be, of course, this flayed one here into the normal battle sister. Three attacks hitting on threes. Rerolling. Thank goodness for the rerolling on the Novak. Feeling awakened. Ooh, but still only one hit. Now wounding on threes, but you get to reroll that as well. Gets the wound. A three up armor save. I'm gonna leave it. I'll let you go to injury roll. No!
Oof.
Okay. Well, it's starting to look real bad. That puts the Necrons up at 5 points. And then we'll go ahead, we'll do this the right way. Well, actually, you'd have to go towards the nearest enemy model so you can basically go in and touch her there. All right, and then so that is actually going to be it for charging models. Now we drop to non-charging models. So who would you like to swing with first? You can swing with this guy or either of these two.
Yeah. So I'll go here. He doesn't get awakened by murder because
he didn't charge this round. Yep. So it's three attacks, hitting on threes, but no rerolls this time. Doesn't even need it. Wounding on threes and rerolling because of those claws. Ugh. Okay. Three up armor saves. She makes two. I'm really tempted to reroll that. And I think I will. I'll spend a command point to reroll it. Yes. She survives. Very nice. All right, so then now we go over here. I'll swing with this sister. So she just one attack on a four. No, okay. All right, and then now we've got either your leader or your guy. Yeah,
I'll do the leader first.
Okay.
So two attacks, threes. You did not charge.
Did not charge this round, yeah.
Just this one.
And no, oh wow. Okay, and then now I'll swing this sister into, we'll go into this one here. One attack on a four, no. Okay, and then now last thing to finish up the combat phase, your sword and board Lich Guard.
Two attacks.
Three. Two hits.
No.
Strength six, right?
Yeah, plus one.
I've moved myself out of 6 inches here. So these are just going to be six ups to save. No injury roll. Oh, it's just a flesh wound. Okay. Well, the flesh wound is just as bad for the sisters here because we do go into the morale phase. We do require a break check because we've got 2, 4, 5 out of action, 6, 7 with the flesh wounds. So we do require a break check. Our highest leadership on the board now is going to be 7 from the sisters, I think. When we pass our break check. So that's fine. So we'll go ahead and we'll do a nerve check here for this sister. She's got a +5 to the roll. So basically a 1 or a 2. Okay, we're good there with the 2. And then we'll do for our, she was previously shaken. Now she's potentially not needing a 1 or a 2 again. Oh, there we go. So no shaken models, thankfully for the sisters. We've stabilized a bit, not in the best way, but we'll take it as it comes. Necrons, of course, no break check required, no nerve checks required. And we go into round 4, potentially the last round of the game here. And the sisters roll a 4. And the Necrons roll a 7. So the Necrons take initiative. All right, it is the end of the movement phase for round 4, potentially the last round of the game. Current standings, Necrons 5 to Sisters 2. Necrons with 2 command points. Sisters with 3 command points. Would have been 4 this round, but Sister Juliet was taken out. So, John, tell us what you did with the Necrons.
Yeah, so this flayed one over here kind of failed another charge.
Yes, failed another charge, unfortunately.
Sniper back here is readied. The other 2 flayed ones stayed in combat. Yes. And I also stayed in combat with the
Praetorian. Stayed in combat up here, so it's a pretty short one, yeah. Yep. For the sisters, now that our arco-flagellant Endurant is not shaken, she elected to stay in combat. This sister fell back heroically, a tactical retreat. Mm-hmm. She just kind of came out this way. Now, leaving your Lich Guard here open to my sniper and comm specialist, who the sniper is just within 12 here, so that'll be important. Our banner bearer fell back this way, well, just moved this way, just to consolidate my shooting off here. And then this sister stayed in combat again because she's proven durable. If she can hold it, because now neither of you guys have charged this round. So if she can hold that for one more round, and then we can clear this guy and clear this guy, maybe we've got a fighting chance. So with that, we will go into the shooting phase. Now, are you going to mind shackle scarabs again?
I think you know I'm going to mind shackle scarabs again.
Oh, boy. So who would you like to mind shackle scarab?
This sister right
here. This sister. Okay, so you're going to mind shackle this sister. Let's see. 2 CP. That's your CP for the round. And with a 5, it's not going to be enough. Dodge that one. So then the only readied model is, of course, once again, your sniper specialist here. Who would he like to fire at?
I think he will... He'll shoot here.
Shooting here. Okay, so it'll be a single shot again because we're outside of half range. Hitting on a 4 because of obscurement. Gets the hit. Wounding on a 3. Gets the wound. Thankfully, no mortal wound here, as we just saw. A 3 up armor save. We make it. The Axe of Faith saves coming in big here. Okay, so that's it for ready models. And that's actually it for Necron shooting, because he doesn't have a...
No.
Yeah. All right, so sister shooting. We got to do this. We got to do this the right way. So what we'll do is we'll spend 2 CP for Blessed Bolts here. We'll use the comms bonus on the sniper, and we'll fire everything into your Lich Guard. Okay, so this is going to be 4 shots because we're within half range. Hitting on 3s, rerolling 1s. We get all hits. Very nice. Wounding on 5s. Oh, no wound. I will go ahead and spend a CP reroll to try to get at least 1 wound off. No. Okay, so that's it. That's me on CP for the round. Both players now out of CP. The Blessed Bolts play not coming in at all, but we'll go ahead and we'll keep going with it. That's fine. What we'll do is we'll fire our bolter here into this flayed one. 2 shots hitting on 4s. No. We'll fire our banner sister into the same target. 2 shots on 4s. There we go, 2 hits. Wounds on 4s. 1 wound. No AP.
4.
Oh, man, the sister's having a hard time punching through these metal skeletons. That's going to actually be it for... Oh, no, I do have a bolt pistol here, which I forgot for both rounds here, but that's fine. So we'll do... Actually, I didn't, because she got charged. But now, no charge, so we'll fire a bolt pistol into this flayed one. Single shot. No. Oh, sisters, why? Okay. So that's officially it for the shooting phase. We're all done. We'll go into the fight phase, starting off with no charging models.
No,
there's none. So it's just who would you like to attack with first?
We'll go with the leader.
Go with the leader. That's a smart choice because that Endurant is a wee bit dangerous.
A little scary. A lot of hits. A lot of attacks. Two attacks.
That's 2 hits.
2 hits.
Strength.
Strength. Strength 5.
Strength 5, so no wounds. No wounds. So then I'll actually just go ahead and I'll fight with this sister first because I need to do things intelligently to try to survive. So we'll attack this. We'll attack this flayed one, a single attack on a 4. Can I roll more 2s this game? Who knows? All right, which flayed one would you like to swing with next?
We'll do this one first.
Do this one, okay.
So no awaken or murder.
Okay, but so, still gets 2 hits off of it. 3s to wound, still get to reroll these.
Good thing, too.
2 3 up saves. Oh, she holds. This is the durable sister. All right, so we'll go ahead and do our endurance next. She's got 3d3 hit rolls to make. So let's see, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 attacks. That's pretty good. Hitting on 4s, but getting to reroll all our misses. Thank goodness. Okay, that turned that around. Quick, fast, and in a hurry. Strength 5 to toughness 5, so 4s to wound here. No rerolling on that. That is 4 wounds at AP minus 1.
Okay. Yep, just looking for 4s.
There we go. Failed a few. That's enough to bring you down to an injury roll. Mm-hmm. Can the sisters, can this lobotomized, steroided up sister who obviously profaned against the emperor, prove her worth, prove her penitence, and take out this Xenos filth? No, she can't. Not quite. So that'll, flip that over. There's a single flesh wound one there. Well, you know, she gave it her honest effort. Also, I realized she would have only been hitting on 5s thanks to the flesh wound, but I think it worked out anyway, because I think I rolled like a butt ton of 5s and 6s anyway for hits. So, delete that comment. You'll get no internet points because I've just realized it at filming. So there you go. So then we come back over here to our last flayed one to round out the combat phase. Doesn't even need to be awakened by murder. He sleeps in the murder. Oh, gosh. Okay, she's done it before. Can she do it again? 2 3 up saves. She can! The durable sister. All right, so that is officially it for the fight phase. Sisters do need to take another break check here. That's it. That's the game right there because the sisters broke. They made it all the way, heroically surviving many, many rounds of combat, dealing wounds, doing their job, but finally, the faith in the Emperor was not enough. It's a Necron victory. Let's talk about it. So there you have it, man, a Necron victory. If I am correct, perhaps your first Necron victory
first
here
Necron,
on the channel?
Yes. First kill team victory of Necrons.
Yes, congratulations.
Thank you. Been a long time.
That was a real knockdown drag out fight. A lot of stalling from the sisters. Mm-hmm. Just kind of like wait, just hold on, not yet. Tried my best. I think the Arcoflagellants made a good account of themselves this time. You know, especially the Endurant holding it in. Those couple rounds of combat there. Unfortunate about that mortal wound for my leader, though. Yeah, for you, fortunate.
The single shot from the Death Mark was
that was pretty cool. That was a very cool moment. Just like you can just imagine him too. Like he's there in the back, all these like insane Necrons with the blood and the flesh, like just going up, and then he's just like, it's just like that mechanical precision. Mm-hmm. Like the sight just. Sees the leader and just
one shot.
That's it. Oh man, so cool. Also, I want to say big shout out to my flamer sister for just being the wall. Mm. She didn't kill much, but my goodness, did she not allow the Necrons past her? You know, if the sisters didn't eventually escape, those that remained, it was not her fault.
Yeah.
You know, she stood in combat till the end, you know. But any big thoughts about the game and all that? Did you like the mission, the board, all that sort of stuff?
Yeah, the mission was interesting. Would have loved to use the special mind shackle, but you know,
yes, yeah,
the sniper's just getting it done.
Yeah, I mean, he's just like, we don't need captives.
Yeah,
just
Flayed Ones continue to impress. Especially with Awakened by Murder.
Yeah, Novok for the reroll hits and their own innate rule to reroll wounds
with the claws. Yeah,
man, just makes them so reliable. Yeah. That's the thing; they're just reliable.
Yeah, still looking for a preferred leader, though. I don't know that the Praetorians have impressed me too much, but
I really liked him as a model in general. Because of that 10-inch move.
The 10-inch move with the fly.
And fly? Yeah. Like, holy cow, man. Like, for such a slow team that Necrons are, like a slow army, to have that, a 10-inch fly model, like,
yeah, my God. Maybe with a different war gear. Maybe the Staff of Light's not the move. Maybe it's War Scythe for them.
That's yeah, probably, that would probably be really nice. Yeah. Yeah. What'd you think of the Sisters, your first time playing them?
I really like them. Like to see more of them in the future.
Yeah,
like you're saying, they're somewhere between Guard and Space Marines, but
yeah,
they pack a punch, they take a hit,
yeah,
and they deal them out too.
Yeah. I eventually I have the kit. I just have to put it together and paint it, like all things. I have a Sister Repentia, and they pack a wallop. They are somewhere in between a Battle Sister and an Arcoflagellant because they have the Axe of Faith save, so they have a 6-up invuln. They have, so then it can become a 5-up invuln with that. Then they have a 5-up feel no pain as well, like the Arcoflagellant. They have the reroll hit rolls like the Arcoflagellant, but what they have are eviscerators. Mm. So they have the, like, it's like strength 6, AP minus 3, damage 2, like giant chain swords. So they're just like, just like carve through enemies. And so I just gotta get it built and painted. So there you have it. Well, John, thank you so much for coming on. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
I hope you enjoyed it.
I did.
And we hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to hit that thumbs up and let us know down in the comments below what you liked, what you didn't like. If you saw any rules errors that we didn't already correct on the screen or anything like that, let us know down in the comments. First person to do that gets 10 internet points. Second person gets 5 internet points. And no points for anybody else. It's just a first and second place kind of thing. And of course, if you want to see these videos in your feed every week, hit that subscribe button. You can do so on the screen now. And if you're interested in supporting the channel, lots of ways to do so in the description. And we'll see you on the next one. Bye.
Bye.